Laudator Jesus Christus. Praised be Jesus Christ. Welcome to all of you joining us for our weekly live broadcast coming to you here from St. Peter's Square for the Sunday midday recitation of the Angelus prayer led by Pope Francis. Today on this 2nd of October 2022, from wherever you're joining us, a warm welcome. A special welcome as well to those broadcasters who link up with us, and they include Luminous Radio India, Radio Maria England, Atmar Darshan Television India, Shalom Television India, EWTN Television, the Salt and Light Television, and Shalom World Television Networks USA, the Catholic Faith Network, and Catholic Television, and as well all of you joining us through other broadcasters around the world, or watching on our Facebook live feed, our YouTube live feed right now, or later on demand. Right now you're seeing images of the Apostolic Palace. We're zooming in on the window where Pope Francis traditionally gives his Sunday Angelus address, which is usually preceded by reflections that he wishes to offer to those present. You can see the crowds in the square there. Quite a few today on this wonderfully beautiful, mild September, or no, October, that is, we're already in October, October Sunday, who come here for the weekly Angelus, those pilgrims who are just visiting Rome, even Romans who are in town, come out for the Sunday Angelus and the Pope's Apostolic Blessing following the Angelus prayer there. The Angelus prayer, by the way, can be found by clicking the Pray with the Pope on the Angelus tab, the Pray with the Pope menu on the Angelus tab of the Vatican News website, vaticannews.va, or also on the app. So you can join in the prayer and see the text of it there on our website or our app. In just a few moments, Pope Francis will be appearing there at that window. And for our radio listeners, there's quite a crowd here that the television viewers here can, of course, see clearly. Many with signs representing the parishes they come from, or the organizations they represent, or the religious orders to which they belong. Oftentimes, following the Angelus prayer and the Apostolic Blessing, Pope Francis greets those crowds in the square. And here we see Pope Francis approaching the raised podium there before the window, now waving to those below to their applause.
Cari fratelli e sorelle, buongiorno.
Dear brothers and sisters, buongiorno.
L'andamento della guerra in Ucraina.
The course of the war in Ukraine has become so serious, devastating, and threatening as to cause great concern. Therefore, today I would like to devote the entire reflection before the Angelus to this. Indeed, this terrible and inconceivable wound to humanity, instead of healing, continues to shed even more blood, risking to spread further. I am deeply saddened by the rivers of blood and tears spilled in these months. I'm saddened by the thousands of victims, especially children, and the destruction which has left so many people and families homeless and threatened vast territories with cold and hunger. Certain actions can never be justified, never. It is disturbing that the world is learning the geography of Ukraine through the names such as Bucha, Irpin, Mariupol, Izium, Zaporizhia, and other areas, which have become places of indescribable suffering and fear? And what about the fact that humanity is once again faced with the atomic threat? It is absurd. What is to happen next? How much blood must still flow for us to realize that war is never a solution, only destruction? In the name of God, and in the name of the sense of humanity that dwells in every heart, I renew my call for an immediate ceasefire. Let there be a halt to arms, and let us seek the conditions for negotiations that will lead to solutions that are not imposed by force, but consensual, just, and stable. And they will be so if they are based on respect for the sacrosanct value of human life, as well as the sovereignty and territorial integrity of each country, as well as the rights of minorities and legitimate concerns. I deeply deplore the grave situation that has arisen in recent days with further actions contrary to the principles of international law. It increases the risk of nuclear escalation, giving rise to fears of uncontrollable and catastrophic consequences worldwide. My appeal is addressed first and foremost to the President of the Russian Federation, imploring him to stop this spiral of violence and death, also for the sake of his own people. On the other hand, profoundly saddened at the immense suffering of the Ukrainian people as a result of the aggression they have suffered, I address an equally confident appeal to the President of Ukraine to be open to serious proposals for peace. I urge all the protagonists of international life and the political leaders of nations to do everything possible to bring an end to this war without allowing themselves to be drawn into dangerous escalations, and to promote and support initiatives for dialogue. Please let the younger generations breathe the salutary air of peace, not the polluted air of war, which is madness. After 7 months of hostilities, let us use all diplomatic means, even those that may not have been used so far, to bring an end to this terrible tragedy. War in itself is an error and a horror. Let us trust in the mercy of God, who can change hearts, and in the maternal intercession of the Queen of Peace, as we raise our supplication to Our Lady of the Rosary of Pompeii, spiritually united with the faithful gathered at her shrine and in so many parts of the world.
Et concepit Spiritu Sancto.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum. Benedicta tui mulieribus et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ecce ancilla Domini.
Fiat mihi secundum verbum tuum.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Et verbum caro factum est.
Et habitavit in nobis.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ora pro nobis, Santa Dei Genitris.
Ut digne ficiamur promissionibus Christi.
Gratiam tuam, questum Domine, mentibus nostris infunde, ut angelo nunciante, Christi fili tui, incarnationem cognovim, per passionem eius et crucem, resurrectionis gloriam perducamur, per Christum Dominum nostrum.
Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Pro fidelibus defunctis, requiem aeternam dona eis Domine.
Et lux perpetua luce eis.
Requiescant in pace.
Amen.
Sit nomen Domini benedictum.
Ex hoc nunc et usque in saeculum.
Aiutorium nostrum in nomine Domini.
Qui fecit caelum et terram.
Benedicat vos, omnipotens Deus, Pater, et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus. Amen.
And we've just heard Pope Francis' strong, powerful appeal for peace in Ukraine. And dear brothers and sisters, I'm close to the people of Florida and of Cuba, hit by the terrible hurricane there. I'm close to all those suffering and the victims, and for all those showing solidarity. And I'm very sorry to hear of the victims and those hurt after a soccer game in Indonesia, the victims of that terrible stampede there. And then this evening, or in these days, there will be a projection of the life of St. Peter on the facade of St. Peter's Basilica. From 9 to 11 p.m., it will be happening during the evenings, this projection on the life of St. Peter, on the life of his mission of St. Peter. And I greet all of you, Romans and pilgrims from various countries, families, parish groups, associations. And we greet those from various dioceses from Italy,
and
those from Germany as well.
Corbetta,
and as well,
Formia,
greetings from other areas, other groups from parts of various parts of Italy. And I greet all. I wish all of you a good Sunday, and please remember to pray for me. Have a good lunch and arrivederci. Those are, as customarily happens after the blessing, Pope Francis offers his thoughts and his special greetings, and as well his thoughts. He was about the hurricane victims in Cuba and Florida, the terrible stampede in Indonesia following a football match there, and the projection of the life of St. Peter on the Basilica, the facade of St. Peter's Basilica, that will be happening during these days. But, of course, his key words were on the terrible situation in Ukraine, where he expressed his sadness over the thousands of victims, the worry over the atomic threat that an escalation could pose, and calling ardently with all his heart for an immediate ceasefire. He also made a direct appeal to the President of the Russian Federation, to the President of Ukraine, to do all they can to halt the violence, to come to dialogue, to work for peace, as well as all diplomatic efforts of leaders around the world to work in that direction. He said, "Let us trust in the mercy of God who can change hearts, and in the maternal intercession of Mary, Queen of Peace." With that, we conclude this broadcast of the Sunday Angelus. Thank you all for joining us. My thanks to my colleagues and technicians, technical workers who've made all this possible. And of course, thanks, of course, to all of you for joining us. A blessed Sunday to you all. Laudetur Jesus Christus. Praised be Jesus Christ.